Holy Spirits. The Lord be with you. It's a privilege to be here with you this morning to celebrate this baccalaureate mass as we bid farewell to these seniors. Of course, they'll have their thing on Sunday as well. But it's a time for us to gather to give thanks and praise to God for all the good things that He has accomplished through this class, a chance to celebrate accomplishments, and also a time to send them off. Future that God has prepared for them. We also remind ourselves many times that we forget that God is with us. We forget that He is somebody who loves us, guides us, protects us. And so when we forget those things, we ask always for mercy and forgiveness. Lord Jesus, who sent the other cry of heart, Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, who came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you heal us and bring us your strength, Lord, have mercy. Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, restorer and lover of innocence, direct the hearts of your servants towards yourself, that those you have set free from the darkness of unbelief may never stray from the light of your truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
Because there arose no little dissension in the faith. Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine grower. He takes away every branch in me that does not bear fruit. Everyone that does, he prunes so that it bears more fruit. You are already pruned because of the word that I spoke to you. Remain in me as I remain in you. Just as a branch cannot bear fruit on its own unless it remains on the vine, so neither can you unless you remain in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. Whoever remains in me and I in him will bear much fruit, because without me you can do nothing. Anyone who does not remain in me will be thrown out like a branch and withered. People will gather them and throw them into a fire, and they will be burned. Remain in me, and my words remain in you. Ask for whatever you want, and it will be done for you. By this is my Father glorified, to bear much fruit, and become my disciples. The Gospel of the Lord. Some of you may be familiar with very well-known Trappist monk of the 20th century here in the United States named Thomas Merton. Now, he was a Trappist monk at the Gethsemane Monastery in Kentucky. But he's well known all over the world for the things that he had written, his own life stories, or conversion story of that. And one day, he received a request from a man who was writing a book titled Success. And this author wanted him to maybe make a statement or say a few words and all that. And Thomas Merton rather angrily wrote back and said, I do not consider myself to be a success. And if I did become a success because of something that I've written, a book, or anything like that, it was negativity and stupidity on my part, and I promise never ever to do that again. Then he relates the story about when he was at Columbia of a scandal. And it dealt with a man who was voted at best dressed, trading with somebody on the journals of the yearbook that they had, who had gotten most likely to succeed. And so they traded off. This guy was voted the best dressed and ended up becoming most likely to succeed. The problem is that nobody knew what happened to the guy after he left Columbia University. Merton said, the problem is, if we are too focused in on success, we're going to forget how to live. That's the part of education. Now, obviously, I am not saying to the seniors, I the salvation of the vow can't please God. But it's also true that it has to be a living faith that will produce fruit by good deeds. It's not enough simply to baptize. It's not simply enough to have professed your faith externally. It is not enough for you to go to 12 years of Catholic education, so forth and so on. It is a continuing work of cooperating with Jesus Christ in his work of redemption. We all have a part of it. You seniors, as you go forward, your work is really just begun in that aspect. Now, he also says those who remain on the vine will expect pruning to bear more fruits. Seniors, I am sure I have to tell you that as you go forth in life, you're going to experience some joys, but you're also going to experience sorrow and failure. Rather than viewing it as a defeat, view it as a chance of God maybe refocusing your vision. Sometimes we lose it as we go through life. And God comes along and proves. So all those contradictions, all those difficulties in life are ways that you will be able, in your suffering, to produce the fruit that God desires for you. And really, to tell you the truth, isn't that what you had here in your various activities? If you were a serious student, you spent maybe longer hours than you probably would have wanted to in trying to master a particular subject. I have to tell the athletes, it takes a lot of work if you want to be halfway decent. Football, volleyball, basketball, soccer, whatever. It takes a lot of work if you're in the arts or creative. Music, one acts, whatever else. If you want to be good, it's going to require a little bit of suffering. And that will still continue as you go forward. Now it's going to hurt, yes, that pruning happen. But in the end, look what God will do. You might be surprised later on in life what will happen. There's also something else, too. We also have to be very, very cautious about that whole temptation we call success. There's a lot of times we tell people to view how God favors us. And that may very well be true most of the time. But the problem is that people will go to lengths to become successful and they will forget how to live. You have the gospel, you have the teachings of the church that have been drilled in your head. But it's a way to help you to live. Because a lot of people be successful, they'll forego their faith. They'll wander the town. They'll get half-hearted commitments. The sad thing is, they'll never be able to bear that fruit. It cannot be that way with you. We have a lot of half-hearted people out there. They're making capital only in England or us. I call you to be committed followers of Jesus Christ. Because it's going to be something that not only your own relationship with God, but also people, other people will see it by the deeds of you. When you were here especially in so many community service projects, I thank especially those of you who were runners for the fish drives that we got. Hopefully some of you have it to be shaped right now. The bottom line is it wasn't meant to stop there. Rather than go forward. SCOTUS is a committed to being disciples, in word as well as in deed. And understand this. Those who don't, Jesus makes it very clear, there is eternal consequences for ignoring that call. For choosing to instead be a worldly success, rather than be a quote-unquote success in the eyes of God. You've seen it before. You know, you walk out after a storm, and a lot of wind and everything else, you see branches along the ground. They were on that tree, because they weren't receiving that light. The tree itself was ready to be knocked down by whatever storms and light came along. Stay close to the faith. Stay close.
God's goodness and mercy, we offer him now our petitions.
We pray for the administration, faculty, and staff of the Social Health Department for our growth during these past 6 years. We pray especially for Mr. Dewey, Mrs. Moody, Mrs. Thompson, and Mrs. Sauer. We ask that you bless them with happiness and renewed hope. We pray to the Lord. We pray for our parents, may they continue to guide and nurture us as we grow, and may they have a much loved and appreciated family. We pray to the Lord. We pray that we, graduating class of 2021, may have the courage to share our gifts with our community. May we be free to shape the future of peace and justice for all. We pray to the Lord. We pray for our friends who have shared with us over the years all the laughter, tears, heartaches, and happiness, that they may know how much we love and cherish them. We pray to the Lord. We pray for the sake of our community and for all of us in our lives to help. Help them to heal their wounds. We pray to the Lord. We pray for those in our families and in our schools and parish communities who have died and are now without students. Teach us to be comforted to one another. We pray to the Lord. Finally, let us pray for the graduating class of 2021 for the new class of 2021. We pray to the Lord.
Lord our God, we praise and we thank you for all of your gifts and blessings. We thank you for the gift of these seniors and the many ways that they have shared their gifts and talents with all of us. They are signs to us of your goodness, and so we offer you these petitions we have spoken, those we hold in our hearts. We ask you to grant them all through Christ our Lord. Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these paschal mysteries, that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, Lord. But in this time above all, we'll lodge you ever gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. When the old order destroyed and universe cast down as we do, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts it with praise. and even the heavenly powers of the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as a acclaim. Setting, pure sacrifice being offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once giving you thanks, he said a blessing, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which you poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Lord, we pray upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we were nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body and one spirit in Christ. May he make us the eternal offering to you so that we can obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with blessed Duns Scotus, and with all the saints of whose constant intercession in your presence we rely upon faith and help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world, be pleased to confirm in faith and charity or grow the church on earth, and your servant Francis, our Pope, and George, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom we have summoned before you. Your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself while your children scattered throughout the world. Our departed brothers and sisters, to all who are pleased with your passing through this life, give kind of things to your people. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, for whom we bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. 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 At the same Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you all. Offer each other a school approved sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world, as well as all the suffer the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. prayers that this most holy exchange by which you have redeemed us may bring your help in this present life and ensure for us eternal gladness through Christ our Lord. Lord, be with you.
And
the Almighty God bless you, Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Go forth, ask God.